Free for all, over every limitation, free for all. is free indeed. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed, church.
Yeah.
Amen. Give God a praise today. There's only a few of us in this room today. So we're going to have to be the mighty few. Let's give God a praise this morning. Let's give God a shout. Come on.
Sing a little louder.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Can you hear me? Praise the Lord, my brothers and sisters in Christ. What a day. We praise God for what He can do. We are worshiping a God who shows up where Mary was doing something else. And Mary wondered and said, what kind of greeting is this? This is the God we do worship. Where He can show up in your house unexpectedly. He can show up in our lives unexpectedly. Asking you to do something we have never done before. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. This is the God we do worship. So I want to welcome you all to this particular service, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome people from Africa, Europe, and all over the world in Sarasota, Florida. We love you. We are praying for you. We do believe that whatever we are going through right now, God is with us. My name is Eric. I'm the pastor at Mount Hope United. I'm the pastor at Mount Hope. We want to share a couple announcements, just one announcement with you. I have a good news for you. Next week, Sunday 17-20 in 2021, we are going to meet again in person. We are meeting with the social distances protocol again. So please, next week, both services, 9:30 and 11, and we are going also to do the same ministry online. You know, particularly my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ who are having health, where your health is at risk, I will really invite you just to keep on connecting with us online. But feel free, my fellow brothers and sisters, to join us online, in person, and in parking lot. So this time, let me just give a very short prayer, and then I'm going to invite Brother Jacob again to give us a song. Let us pray for Brother Joe Groff. As we speak, he's at Sparrow, but things are getting better and better. I'll keep on remembering him with his family in your prayer. Let us pray for our nation. Let us invite God. Don't give up. You know, sometimes we Christians, we feel like, where is God? Since we have been praying for mercy, but God is not showing up. Ah, my friend, God does show up. You don't have an idea. Don't give up on your prayer. Keep on praying. Let us pray in Jesus' name. Our precious God, Heavenly Father, Holy and Living God, we come together in one accord to thank you for this morning. Lord, I invite you right now, Lord, according to your word, because it is written. You said from the book of Jeremiah 33, verse 3, you said, invoke my name, and I will show you things that you have never seen before. Father, it is a command. You told us to do so. That's why we are here, standing, kneeling, our God is singing, but in one accord. We pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, pour out your Holy Spirit over us. Let your Holy Spirit, Father, Lord, increase in our lives in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for your presence, Lord, to increase in our nation in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Father, as we stand in one accord with the power of Jesus Christ, we speak, Lord, against any other spirit which does not confess your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, be removed. Father, Lord, the darkness, O Lord, in our country, we remove them with the power of word of God in Jesus' name. Listen again. We are not afraid of you because we are the children of God. We pray in Jesus' name for the cross, as it says, Father, Lord, Jesus Christ on the cross. You said it is finished. We speak for the cross of Jesus Christ. In our nation, we speak for the cross of Jesus Christ in our homes, the cross in our churches, the cross in our walking, in our speech, in everything we do, we speak for the cross of Jesus Christ in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for Brother Joe Groff in Jesus' name. Lord, we speak.
speak for your cross in this life. In Jesus' name, glory, hallelujah. Bring healing, bring peace and restoration, Father, blessings in Jesus' name. Lord, we pray for those who are struggling, Lord, financially, spiritually, intellectually. Lord, we send blessings in the name of Jesus Christ. We send favor upon their lives in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah. Bless our church, Lord. Use us, Father, for the sake of your glory. Reveal your glory, because it is written, you said, upon my rock you build the church. Father, this is your church. We pray for the power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, to protect us, to bless us, to use us powerfully in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We bless you, we worship you, Lord, for this moment. Be with us, O God, as we praise you and as we share your word. Be with us. We give praise and honor because you've heard us. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. We pray together and we say, amen. 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 Today we are just for you going to pray your Lord prayer later on. We're just going straight to the service. I'm inviting Brother Jacob to give us a song.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Glory to Jesus.
Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, my goodness. So God is doing something in our lives. Just pay attention to what God is doing in your life right now. Fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, this is the time we want to hear the word together. Before I share the word, I want to communicate with you, my fellow brothers and sisters. Wherever you are, I want you to be with me. Be with me from the beginning of this message until the end. There is a reason why I'm asking you this. You can take your cup of coffee, a juice, a water, just make sure it's next to you. This message, in order for us to fully understand, I have to do it from the beginning until the end. And I'll be patient. And I thank God. I want to say I thank God because COVID-19 taught us to be patient. Friend, if the COVID told us to stay home for the whole year, 2020, I believe that you're going to bear with me for a 20-minute above for this service. So don't check your time yet until I finish. As I said, bear with me until I finish, because this is the word from the Lord. Let us pray. Eternal God, Holy and Living Father, we give you praise and we bless your living name for this moment. Father, we thank you as I stand before your children, God. I pray, God, that you alone can speak through your vessel. Holy and Living God, pour out your Holy Spirit to open our eyes, our ears. Lord, as I stand before your children, wherever they are, God, in person, pray, God, may you be increased as I decrease. In Jesus' name, amen. So, friend, and now we are all this together. And we are going as, we should know that today we are doing something different in terms of all the things we do technology-wise. Friend, fasting is not only a requirement for believers. It's not a requirement for believers. But fasting is a command from Jesus Christ. Not only a command, but Jesus Christ himself fasted. Fasted. Brothers and sisters in Christ, I have a slide with you on the screen. If Muslims believe in fasting and prayer, there's a picture of Muslims there that they are praying. If they believe in fasting and prayer, and they do it for 40 days on Ramadan, they do it. If the Hindus and Buddhists believe in fasting and prayer, and they do it without complaint, then I believe the Church of Jesus Christ should take also what the Bible teaches about fasting and prayer. Friend, Jesus Christ, our role model, fasted for 40 days. Elijah and Moses fasted for 40 days. Paul fasted for 7 days, 10 days, 40 days. When you read the Bible, you are going to understand that Paul was always in the spirit of fasting. Peter did fast for 3 days. The early church had a day of fasting. Early church. The Bible teaches that if you are a believer, you will fast. So in other words, friend, what I'm talking about, in order to understand what God has for us on the power of fasting and prayer.
Let's look at what happened when you fast. What happened when we fast? And there is a scripture here that it doesn't talk about the fasting, but this will help us to understand the meaning of fasting. Let's read Exodus 17. Exodus 17, 11 to 12. I have the word on the screen there. Exodus 17, 11 to 12. Friend, it is a story. It is a story about the Israelite fighting against Amalek. And God commanded Moses and said, go on up to the mountain and lift up your hands. And the Bible says, as long as Moses lifted up his hand up and lifted up his hand, the Israelites were winning. They were winning the battle. And we are told that Aaron and the other priests, Ur, helped Moses' hands to remain up so that they keep on winning. But my friend, I want you to catch this. The Bible says, as long as Moses had physical obedience, he was winning the battle in the unseen world. And the victory, friend, came because of his physical obedience. Hallelujah. Physical obedience. This story, friend, is very important today as we are fasting and praying. Because it reinforces the fact that physical obedience brings spiritual release. Let me say it again. I have the word again on the screen. Physical obedience brings spiritual release. Friend, there is a connection, if you don't know, there is a connection between what we do physically and what happens spiritually. There's a connection. What we do in the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ can affect what is happening in the unseen world. Moses was raising up his hand physically. Why? Because God told Moses to do it. He told Moses, you're going to do it. The Bible says, listen, whenever his hand started getting tired, the Israelites were losing. In other words, when his hand was going down, angels who were helping the Israelites in their fight starting to withdraw. They started to withdraw. The Israelites were losing the battle. Devil is losing the battle. But when his hand went up, the angel could come and help them to win the fights. Here is the point, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. As long as Moses obeyed God to raise up his hand, that's a physical act. The battle was won. The fight was won. In other words, the victory came because of Moses was doing something physical. If his hand goes up, they start winning. If his hand starts going down, they start losing. I love it. I love it. The scripture in the book of 1 Timothy chapter 2 verses 8, it says this. I have it there. It says this. I desire therefore that the men pray everywhere, lifting up holy hands, with vowed wrath and doubting. And when we look at the meaning of wrath, means do not get mad at God. When God gives you an instruction, do not get mad. And the word doubting means do not question God. What good does lift up the hands and bring, can bring or cannot bring? Do not question God. Sometimes in the church, you know, people are putting their hand, but God can tell you, take that hand out of your pocket and lift it up. And you don't need to question God and say, why am I going to do that? Do not question that, God. When God says, lift that hand up, we do it. So the point here is, the truth is, physical obedience brings spiritual reward. That's the truth. Brothers and sisters, listen to this. And I have the word there. How much more, if the rising of the hands bring victory in the old covenant, the time of Moses, how much more? And what could fast and prayer do under the new covenant of Jesus Christ? As an example, who did fast for 40 days, what can fast bring to us? If we follow him by setting aside time to fast and pray, our physical obedience will bring spiritual blessings, especially when you do it without doubt and without questioning God and say, what does it do to fast? Fasting does good. Why? Because God says, do it. It is not me. It's God says, do it. In the book of Matthew 17, we'll look at later. We are going to know the reason why God says, do fast and pray. My beloved in Christ, as a church, a new generation, in the modern church we are living right now, we have reduced everything down to feelings and intellects. Everything has been reduced to feelings and intellects, and not to any physical actions. This is what we say in modern days as a church. I feel like I'm humble, so I'm not going to get on my knees before the Lord. Everything has been reduced to feelings. I feel like I'm worshiping the Lord only on the inside. Now, that's what we say. I'm worshiping the Lord on the inside. On the inside. I don't have to clap my hands for God. Everything is now in the inside. We are at the time where people are now saying, I don't have to pray. I don't have to raise up my hands. Even at home, at your own home, you don't have to raise up the hand for God. Everything has been now inside. I don't have to shout for joy in the church and shout for joy in my house and say, praise the Lord. I don't have to stand up and worship in God physically with my whole body, because God knows my heart. You know what we say here? I feel faith in me. I feel faith in me. I don't have to risk anything because I have faith in my heart. Everything has been reduced down to a modern church, to the internal stuff, and there is no outcome manifestation. I want you to think with me with this statement. I have it there. I want you to think with me with this statement, and you give yourself an answer. If you tell your wife or your husband or children or grandchildren that I love you, but you never show them that love on the outside, they are going to question you. Try it. They're going to question you. Your grandchild will pick up the phone and say, Dada, Grandpa, no, that is not a good love here. I don't see anything out of you. It's the same with God. Same with God. God is saying, sometimes I demand my people a physical act of obedience before I release the spiritual reward and blessings. A fasting and prayer is one of those acts of obedience. There are times, friend, when God requires all of us for a physical action. You know, one thing we should know, the world today we are living has told us, all of us, Christians, Muslims, Hindus, Buddhists, all of us, the world today has told us to wear masks and stay social distances. And no one questioned that. And we are doing it well. Oh, the entire 2020 just ended up wearing masks and social distances everywhere. And by the way, the good news is, many of us were not able to see each other on Christmas. Even your own grandchildren, you were not able to see them because the world has told us to wear masks and social distances. That is a physical obedience. And God is also asking us, God is also inviting us to present ourselves with a physical obedience. Because there is a connection between the physical obedience and what is going to happen in the spiritual world. My brothers and sisters in Christ, Moses, with his hand up, that is a physical obedience. He listened to God and he was up like that. It was really fast. With his physical obedience, victory was for them. Physical obedience released power, spiritual power. Physical obedience released favor from God. Physical obedience released help from God. Physical obedience released protection we need from God. Physical obedience released healing, miracles, and blessing that you haven't seen yet, but it's coming. It's coming. Let me prove it. That is coming from the word, from the book of Daniel. The book of Daniel, I have the word there. The book of Daniel, chapter 10, and verses 3 to 7. I have the word there. Daniel was saying, I ate no pleasant food. I ate no pleasant food. You know the meaning of that? Daniel was just saying, I became vegetarian. I became vegetarian. In other words, Daniel was saying, I ate no desirable food. And God's response was, Daniel, you are greatly desired by me. In other words, Daniel is saying, I ate no desirable food, and I became a man greatly desired by God during my 21 days fasting. Daniel had to look for God's favor by going through a physical sacrifice where he put all desirable food away. He did it. And when he did, God released an angel. The Bible says the angel. God released an angel from heaven only for him because he put himself in a situation where he feels the physical pain. God released an angel. You know, sometimes I wonder, people, this generation, we are trying to
skip some of the language like angels. They do exist, angels. Let me tell you, they do. If they did not exist, Jesus could not come because God sent the angel. Let me explain to you how the angel works. By the way, for your own information, I want you to get this from now on. I want you to get this, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. Angels in heaven, they are jobless. They don't have a job. The only job they have is this. They worship God in the morning, afternoon, every day they just worship God. Holy, hallelujah, holy are you God. That's what they do. They don't have a specific job. They don't have a job. So the only way the angels to get jobs is when God sent them on earth. And God sent angels on earth in two ways. First one, God, he can just wake up in the morning and say, I'm sending an angel for my own assignment. Like what happened to Mary, the mother of Jesus. The angel just shows up and say, greetings, favored woman. That angel came directly from God with a God mission. That's number one. And the second way, angels can visit us here on earth from heaven is when you and I pray. Daniel prayed and God released an angel. It is not only Daniel. Read your Bible, you're going to understand that every time when people praise, God releases angels and say, go. So you can hire an angel when you pray directly from heaven. The Bible says in the book of Daniel, chapter 10, verses 12 to 13, I have the word there. Listen to this. The Bible says the prayer of Daniel was heard on the first day. But his answer was delayed because of the priest of Persia, of kingdom, resisted the angel. And then God sent a backup. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Again, another angel came. Catch this, my fellow brothers and sisters. Our prayers are being heard. Are being heard. We don't need to stop praying after 2 or 3 days of your physical obedience. You know, sometimes it looks like nothing is changing when we pray. And we wonder if God is hearing us. I want to tell someone this morning to keep on praying, keep on presenting your physical obedience to God. God will send a backup to show you that he is God. God will send a backup to show us that he is God. Daniel did not stop praying. And Daniel, those days, things were not easy at all. It was hard. But Daniel kept on praying. And on the last day, after 21 days, God sent a backup. Angel Michael. Daniel. God released another blessing. Beloved in Christ, as I said before, bear with me today. I want to finish this with you. Let me share my personal story. And I have a picture of me on the mountain. You can stay there. For those who went with me to Africa University, they know well what I'm talking about. Because we climbed that mountain with them. And we did pray and have a Holy Communion on that mountain. Friend, I grew up in a Christian family. I'm a fallen man. I messed up. If you want to know the things I messed up, check with my wife. She will tell you. I grew up in that Christian family. So one day God opened a door for me. I left my own country, Congo, and I went to Zimbabwe. While I was in Zimbabwe, doing my studies.
friend I check out, and you know, I never had a bank account, so I had only $20. $20 remained in my wallet. $20 for 4 months as my pocket money. $20. So I checked out. I said, oh my goodness, this is the only $20 I have. I took the $20. I went to the bookshop on campus. I bought a Bible. And I took the Bible. I went back into my room. I was reading for an hour. And I came across to the story of Jesus Christ fasting for 40 days. I read it again. I read over and over. And I said to myself, I'm going to fast. So I went to see my friends, they were Christians. And you know what? They used to sing in the choir. One actually used to play keyboard. Another one used to sing bass. They were good friends. But I don't sing. They are my friend. So I went to see them and said, can we do something? And said, what is it, Brother Eric? Those days, I was not even doing theology. I was doing agriculture. And said, I said to them, can we do something? And said, what is it? Can we fast together for 21 days? And they were so excited, and they agreed. We agreed together not to tell anybody on campus. And we agreed together to stay away from TV. And you know, we love soccer. And we stay away from TV for 21 days. And we stay away from food. We're not eating food. The only thing we used to eat, here was 2 slices of bread and 1 cup of coffee at 6 p.m. And we also stay away from walking in a crowd with people. And we set up a time to pray 3 times per day. 5 a.m., 12, and 5 p.m. We started the journey. Surprisingly, on the 10th, after 10 days, one of my friends came to us and said, brothers, I'm not going to make it. It's too tough. So guys, carry on. And we bless him. And we told them, do not tell anybody that we are fasting. And after 15 days, the other friend of mine came and said, Brother Eric, oh my goodness, I can't carry on. I'm done. I have to eat. And I bless him. Say, do not tell anybody that we are fasting. And our focus when we're fasting, we just say, God, we need more of you, less of us. That was our prayer. Friend, I carry on the journey by myself. I carry on. Friend, I want to be open. On the 20th, after 20 days, I was tired. I was completely tired. And I asked God, please help me to finish the race. I was completely tired. I could not even go for classes. I cried to God. I said, Lord, help me. I need more of you, less of me. I need more of you, less of me. I cried. On the last day, on the 21st, I could not even stand up and pray while I was sleeping. On the 21st, I saw a dream. It was around 4 a.m. I saw a dream. I saw a man standing, looking at me straight, wearing white, and the light was shining. And the man said, I heard you. The man said, I heard you. The man opened the Bible. He opened a book and opened a book and went his finger on the book from Psalm 20. If you have a Bible at home, or you can Google Psalm 20. And the man showed it to me and said, "Read it." And I started reading it. While I was reading, in my roommate was studying at 4 a.m. in my room. He was studying. He looked at me. I was just, my mouth was moving, but he could not hear my voice. The only voice he heard, he was at the end of my reading. When I said, "Praise the Lord, amen," I opened my eyes. And he looked at me like crazy. I pick up the Bible, I went on that mountain, you can see that picture, and I praise God and said, "Lord, you are so faithful. Lord, thank you, Jesus." Friend, why am I sharing this with you? Friend, I'm here today. It is not about me. I'm just nothing. When I look at myself, when I look at where I came from, I'm nothing. I'm nothing. If it was not about Jesus Christ. I'm not even qualified to stand before you and preach the gospel to many people, and people are greater than me. I'm not even qualified, but by God's grace and God's favor, when I gave my life physically with his physical obedience, and release that favor. Release it. God release the blessing. God release, and God said, "I will raise you up for my glory to preach the message." That's why I'm here, friend. That's why I'm here. Brothers and sisters in Christ, there are times in our lives as Christians where God comes to us not with a demand but a challenge. You don't have to do it. You don't have to do it. You are not more holy if you fast. You are not. But it is a divine challenge to all of us. There are times God shows up at the strategic moment in our lives like this we are going through, where God asks the entire congregation and said, "Fast for 21 days. This is the time where you can say to God, "I want a partnership with you." This is the time you and I, we can say, "God, our church wants a partnership with you." This is the time where we can say, "Our family wants a partnership with you again." This is the time where we can say, "Our country wants a partnership with you again." This is the time where we can say, "Our community, our cities wants a partnership with you." This is the time, friend, we can say, "My neighbor wants a partnership with Jesus Christ." This is the time.
Amen.
What we do physically, like Moses, is going to bring a blessing. Catch this. The physical response of Moses by raising up his hands was recognized by God. The physical response of Daniel by not eating a desirable food for 21 days was recognized by God in heaven. The physical response of the lepers who went down on their knees, they went down, was recognized by God in heaven. The physical response of David, who were dancing, David was dancing before the altar, he danced for the Lord, was recognized by God in heaven. What I'm preaching to you is that your physical response you are doing during these 21 days are recognized by God. And God says, "I will bless you for that. I will bring spiritual release for that. In other words, your physical obedience, that means serving others, giving to the church, preaching the gospel, worshiping him through music and dancing, fasting and prayer, are not going in vain at all. God will bring spiritual release. God will bring healing. God will bring restoration to our lands. God will bring restoration to our lives. God will send a favor again to us.
Yes.
That's what happened with your spiritual, with physical obedience. As I'm closing now. Bear with me. This is really powerful. As I'm closing, watch this. Let's look at Matthew 17:17. 1:7, 1:7. Let's look at it. I have the word here. This is a story where the disciples asking Jesus Christ, why are we not casting demons? And Jesus answered them. I love Jesus Christ. He answered them. He said, oh, faithless and preserved generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him here to me. So let's look at these two words. The number one, I have it on the screen. Number one, faithless. The word faithless means not connected to God. So Jesus is saying to them and to us, you have been disconnected from God. You disconnected from the church. You have disconnected from praise and worship. You have been disconnected from being hungry for Jesus. You have disconnected from my presence. And when you disconnect from God, from me, from the church, from praise and worship, you know what happens? Unbeliefs start taking place in you. You are not faith-filled anymore. Unbelief start taking over you. And as a result, you know, when you disconnect yourself from God and from the church, as a result, fear, worries, hopelessness, despair are growing in you. So in other words, what the Bible is saying, Jesus is saying to us, when we are disconnected from the living word of God, then we become faithless. That's number one. Number two, the word, I have it again, preserve, yes, thank you. You know that word means connected to the world. In other words, Jesus is saying you are connected to the world because you are not connected to God because you are too connected to the world. Jesus is saying you are connected to the worldly life. You are picking up stuff that are not supposed to be in your life. You are picking up stuff that I set you free from. Why are you picking them up? You are just like the world. You are connected. You are not connected to me. Then I love Jesus. I know everybody loves Jesus. So then Jesus gave them an answer. Say, you want to fix that good stuff? Jesus answered them and said, if you want to fix this problem of your faithless and preserved life, this is the answer. Now, Matthew 17:21. I have it. You can see it there. Jesus answered them. However, this kind does not go out except by prayer and fasting. Now the question is, what is prayer? Prayer, I have the very short answer for you. Prayer is connecting yourself to God. Jesus said, connect to God, and your life will have that faith. Connect back to God. And the other question is, what is fasting? Fasting is disconnecting yourself from the world. In other words, disconnect yourself from the human desires. That's fasting. So, beloved in Christ, as we begin this year, we are just at the beginning of the year, as we just started, it is good for us to disconnect from the world desires. It is good. It is good for us to be, it's good for us to connect our lives to God. This is the time where you can say, oh God, I'm coming to you. I want more of you and less of me. This is the time church will say, oh God, as a church we are coming to you. We need more of you, less of us. This is the time where the world will say, our nation will say, oh God, we are coming to you. We need more of you in our country, less of us. This is the time. This is the time where you can say, Lord, disconnect. I want to disconnect myself from social media for 21 days. Stay away from social media. It's part of your fasting. 21 days. Just stay away. Don't go to CNN. Don't go to Fox News. Don't go to any news. Stay away from social media for 21 days and connect yourself to the Bible. Read and pray. Connect yourself. This is the time where you can disconnect yourself from taking cookies for 21 days, taking meat for 21 days. When we do that, we are going to experience God peace and God favor again. God blessings will come. When we do that together, my fellow brothers and sisters, God will send angels to us. So I'm inviting Jacob to come. We are just up. I'm inviting you wherever you are. Wherever you are. I want you to join us as a church. It doesn't matter. You can start even today or tomorrow. It doesn't matter. You can start and join us for 21 days. Join us. Stay away from social media for 21 days. You're going to feel that pain. Remember this. Your physical obedience will bring a spiritual release in your life. Your physical obedience is going to bring favor in your life. Your physical obedience will bring peace in your life. Your physical obedience to God will bring more than what you can imagine in your life. I'm inviting you. It doesn't matter how many, but wherever you are, please join us in this journey for 21 days as a church. We are fasting and praying because we believe that God will send us blessing, will send us. So I'm inviting you right now. I'm inviting my friend wherever you are. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you for this moment. Pray with me, my friend. Look at yourself and check in your heart and see where you can fast from. God, there is a lot of ways to do it. And fasting is a command. It's a command. The Bible teaches about fasting. And when we do it together, even our nation, our country, we experience peace. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we bless you. We worship you, God, because you have spoken. Father, Lord, I pray for your spirit to bless my brothers and sisters in Christ. Father, Lord, I pray, God, disconnect us from the things, oh Lord, that pull us back. Disconnect us, Lord, from the things of the world in this journey. We want to connect our lives with you, Christ the Lord. as we begin this year, Lord, help us to connect our life with you. Help us to connect, oh God, our lives with you. 10 days, 21 days, 5 days, 3 days, Lord, we want to connect our lives with you. Bless us as a church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm inviting my brother Jacob to give us the song. Thank you.
Faithfulness, your faithfulness. Thank you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. God bless our bands. Hallelujah. This is what we need physically, and God is doing something spiritually. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Brenda, we want to thank God for being with us from the beginning up to this time, this particular moment. We're just going to invite you to give to our church. We have four ways to give to our church. You can give in person. You can just go online on our website, Mount Hope United Methodist Church, and you can just use your phone. You upload the Vanco app on your phone. You can also mail your check. Friend, let me share this with you. Because your physical acts of giving to this ministry, the gospel will be preached now and forever.
Amen.
So your act of giving to this ministry, it saves souls and help many people. So go online and send your check to our church. I know we know that we are going through a lot, but still God is always blessing us. Amen. Let us receive the blessings. And eternal God, holy and living Father, we pray for this church, Father. Father, I speak for blessings over this church. Pour out your blessing, Lord. See us through as we are presenting ourselves physically during this day, Lord. We pray, God, for your favor. Bless us, release the power, release it.
Yes, sir.
Release it, Lord, from heaven. We release it, Lord. Release it. As we do go through this day of fasting, Lord, release the power and heal our land.
Yes, sir.
Hear the prayers of your children in our country. And release the power. Release backups, Lord. Release them, Lord, so that we all go on our knees and say, this is only God can. Bless the rest of the week. And bless everything, Lord, we do and we say. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Before you know, our friend, we just came up with something at the end of the service just to announce. As we go through prayer and fasting, now we have got two Wednesdays, two weeks remained. We are inviting you to join us on Wednesday at 6:30. Join us online. Those who want to be in person, just to pray from 6:30, we are going to be here with Jacob. And Rocky is going to be with us too. So come, we're just going to spend about 30 minutes and we praise God and 45 minutes as the Spirit leads us. We're not going to sleep in the church. Just join us on Wednesday, starting this Wednesday, 6:30. Join us. May God bless you. If you need more details, give me a call or call Jacob. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah.